While many of us are still afraid to travel far and wide due to the pandemic, some are more comfortable visiting places that are just close to home. If you're a Metro Manila or Calabarzon resident, one of these destinations is Antipolo. Hey there, poor traveler, we are Vince and Yosh. We recently traveled to Antipolo to find out what it's like, what has changed, and what you need to know when planning a trip in the new normal. We'll be creating a series of videos that feature Antipolo day trip itineraries. In this video, we're focusing on the artistic and romantic side of the city and zoom in on three attractions: Pinto Art Museum, Crescent Moon Cafe, and Kaulayaw Coffee. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified when we upload new travel videos.
Nandito kami sa Antipolo Rizal and first stop namin is Crescent Moon Cafe.
Crescent Moon is an art space and pottery store, and it offers pottery classes and other creative workshops. But it is best known for its restaurant, which serves mostly Southeast Asian cuisine. It is a staple on lists of must-try restaurants in Rizal, so we were really excited.
On a weekend, medyo traffic papunta dito. Before kayo pumunta o lumabas ng bahay o pumunta ng mga establishments, make sure na may mask kayong dala. So, kakain na muna kami magla-lunch. So, walang bakante, pero maghintay na kami. Kasi...
Unfortunately, the place was full and the staff said we would have to wait 2 to 3 hours for a table.
So, might as well, mag-video na lang tayo dito para makita ninyo kung ano yung itsura ng restaurant. Yan. Kumita niya may mga fish dyan. Ngayon, 12:30 PM. Ang next na available na table yata eh. Tama di ba? As 2 o'clock?
2 to 3 o'clock PM
na. So, didiretso na lang kami ng Pinto Art Museum. Sadly, hindi kami matitikman yung food dito.
After looking around and enjoying the view of the adjacent garden and the koi pond, we decided to not wait and just have lunch at Pinto Art Museum instead. Yep, Pinto Art Museum also has a restaurant and it's called Cafe Rizal. Because we were desperately famished at this point, we sat and dined first before exploring the museum. We ate at the main restaurant and ordered this seafood pasta, which is oil-based, with generous serving of clams, mussels, and shrimps. This Monte Carlo chicken, which is baked half chicken with Italian herbs, French beans, and sun-dried tomatoes. And this adobo, called Rizal pork adobo, which is an unconventional take on the national dish. Don't leave without trying their tamarind shake.
Sarap, no?
Ang sarap.
Ang sarap. May tamis na asin.
Nasa talaga siyang sampalok.
After this filling but rather expensive lunch, we started exploring. Boy, was I surprised by the sheer size of the place. But wait, let's rewind a little bit.
Nandito kami sa Pinto Art Museum. And nasa Lupsyon subdivision. And before ka makapasok, kailangan magbayad ng 20 pesos para sa parking fee.
We headed straight to the entrance, bought our tickets, and accomplished a health declaration form. Just scan the QR code displayed by the door. Unless you're eating, never remove your face mask when inside the complex, not even when taking photos. There's a lot of Instagrammable spots around and it's very tempting to remove the mask, but don't. Just take a selfie with the mask on. It's not just for your own safety, but also the other visitors. Take your time, appreciate the pieces, and learn about them as you go around. This whole place is huge, so it should take at least 3 hours.
So dahil sa pagod. Ang laki pala ng Pinto Art Museum. 7 galleries lahat na nandito. May malaki pa silang garden. Pagod na kami.
All this walking and admiring got us hungry again. Off we went to our next stop, Kaulayaw Coffee. Unlike most ubiquitous cafes around, this scenic nook was built around the core value of supporting local farmers and suppliers, which is why their tagline is ethically sourced, locally grown. Kaulayaw means intimate companion, an apt moniker given how romantic the setup is. A 3-story balcony-fronted open-air cafe perched on a ridge with a spectacular view of the Metro Manila skyline and surrounding areas, especially at sunset. Kaulayaw is becoming very popular, so expect a queue like this if you visit on a weekend. In reality, it's even longer because there is also a line inside. But the line that really matters is the list that the staff at the door keeps. So, when you arrive, go straight to the staff, get listed, and wait for your name to be called. Once called, you'll be assigned a table. Although it would be nice to be seated closest to the edge, it doesn't matter at the end of the day because anyone can approach the railings to admire the view anyway.
Narinig ko kasi yung place na to is best known talaga for the coffee, more than the food. Diba?
Kombucha tsaka draft beer.
Cheers!
If you need more information about traveling around destinations near Manila, you'll find comprehensive travel guides with sample itineraries on our website, www.theportraveler.net, or check out the links in the description. If you have questions, sound off in the comment section below. You can also follow us on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Just look for @theportraveler, single L. You may also follow and tune in to the Port Traveler podcast on Spotify. That's all for now. Remember, plan smart, travel safe, and make every trip worth it.